Dear students, in the previous lecture we have seen about the prestressed concrete. The next is the analysis of prestressed beams. For the analysis of prestressed beams, we are considering two cases. The case A is stress distribution due to concentric tendon, and the case B is stress distribution due to an eccentric tendon. Firstly, the case A, stress distribution due to concentric tendon. Firstly, CGC means the center of gravity of the concrete, and CGS means center of gravity of the steel. E means there is eccentricity, that means there is a distance between the center of gravity of concrete and steel. If the tendon is a concentric tendon, the eccentricity is equal to 0. If the tendon is an eccentric tendon, that means there will be a value for eccentricity. And WD means it's the dead load, WL means it's a live load, and P is the pre-stressing force. Here we are considering compressive stress as positive and tensile stress as negative. These stresses are developed due to three reasons. One is due to the pre-stressing force. The second one is due to the dead load, and the third one is due to the live load. That means the first one is due to the pre-stressing force, the second one will be due to the moment developed due to the dead load, and the third one will be the moment due to the live load. When a beam is subjected to concentric axial force like this, the beam will be subjected to crushing. As we studied in MOS, when a beam is subjected to an axial force P like this, the stress developed that is equal to P by A. Since the stress due to this P is compressive and the value is P by A, then this is positive and the diagram will be like this. Since the stress will be like this, the stress developed due to this P, that will be the compressive stress, that's why this is positive, and this is an axial force, that's why stress is equal to P by A, and the diagram will be like this, that means stress due to the pre-stressing force, that is P by A. The next is the stress due to moment caused by the dead load as well as live load. By the equation of bending, the stress developed due to the moment, that is equal to sigma is equal to M by Z, where Z is the section modulus. Due to the live load, it will be ML by Z, and due to the dead load, it will be MD by Z. In both the cases, dead load as well as live load, when they are acting at the top of the beam like this, the top portion will be subjected to compression and the bottom portion will be subjected to tension. That means the portion above the neutral axis is positive since it is compressive stress, and the portion below the neutral axis is negative, that means that is tensile. And the expression for these fiber stresses are M by Z. When you combine these stresses, that means P by A, MD by Z and ML by Z, the resultant stress diagram will be like this. That means at the top fiber, it is P by A plus MD by Z plus ML by Z, and at the bottom it is P by A minus MD by Z and minus ML by Z. The next is case B, that is stress distribution due to eccentric tendon. The only one difference is there, that means then you have to consider one more stress, that stress is due to the eccentricity. That means you have to consider the stress, due to eccentric load also. The moment due to eccentricity, that will be P into E. That is the moment due to eccentricity. Since the moment due to eccentricity is PE, that means the stress developed due to eccentricity will be PE by Z. When a beam is subjected to an eccentric load like this, the top portion is subjected, that means the beam will be deflected like this. That means the top portion is subjected to tension and the bottom portion is subjected to compression. That means the top portion is subjected to tension, that means minus PA by Z, and the bottom portion is subjected to compression, that means plus PA by Z. When we combine these four stresses, the resultant will be the working stress at the top fiber will be P by A minus PE by Z plus MD by Z plus ML by Z. At the bottom fiber, that will be P by A plus PE by Z minus MD by Z minus ML by Z. Okay. Then moving on to one example. A pre-stressed concrete beam 200 mm by 300 mm center cross section is used over an effective span of 6 meter to support an imposed load of 4 kN per meter. At the center of span, find the magnitude of concentric pre-stressing force necessary for zero stress at soffit when the beam is fully loaded. The second one is eccentric pre-stressing force located 100 mm from the bottom of the beam, which will nullify the bottom fiber stress due to loading. The given data are, the pre-stressed concrete beam 200 mm by 300 mm means the area of cross section is 200 by 300. Effective span is 6 meter means L is equal to 6 meter. Imposed load of 4 kN per meter means live load is 4 kN per meter. Then we have to find out the concentric pre-stressing force and eccentric pre-stressing force. That means we have to find out the value of P. The first case is if P is concentric and the second case is P is eccentric. Then moving on to the first case. Since the concentric pre-stressing force, that means the value of eccentricity is equal to zero. That means the center of gravity of concrete coincides with the center of gravity of steel. And we have to find out the concentric pre-stressing force necessary for zero stress at soffit. Zero stress at soffit means the bottom fiber stress is equal to zero. If the pre-stressing force is concentric, that means here our case A. For the case A, the bottom fiber stress is P by A minus MD by Z minus ML by Z. Our question is to find out the value of this P when P by A minus MD by Z minus ML by Z is equal to 0. For that, firstly find out what is A. Okay. Here A is equal to 0 because tendon is passing through center of gravity of concrete. Stress at bottom is equal to 0. That means P by A minus MD by Z minus ML by Z is equal to 0. Then we have to find out the value of P from this equation. Then firstly, what is the value of A? Since the cross section is 200 by 300, that means area is equal to 200 into 300. Then next is, what is the value of Z? Since the cross section of the beam is a rectangular cross section, the value of the equation for section modulus, that will be BD square by 6. Okay, that means 200 into 300 square by 6. A is equal to 200 by 300 and Z is equal to 200 into 300 square by 6. Okay, that means you got the value of Z at A. Then lastly, we have to find out what is MD at ML. Since it is a simply supported beam and the simply supported beam is subjected to UDL, that means WD as well as WL, that is UDL. For a simply supported beam subjected to UDL, the ultimate moment or the maximum moment, that will be WL square by 8. Since the live load is 4, that means WL square by 8 is 4 into L square by 8. That means 4 into 6 square by 8. And you got the value of ML. W into L square by 8, that is 4 into 6 square by 8. The next is MD. MD means it is also WL square by 8. That means you have to find out WD. That means dead load, that means the self weight of the beam. The self weight of the beam can be calculated by using the equation density of concrete into area of cross section. That's why 24 into area of cross section is 0.2 into 0.3 into L square by 8. You got all the values except P. You got the value of A, Z, ML and MD. From this we can calculate what is the value of P. P will be 489.6 kN. Okay. Then the second one. Second case that will be, we have to find out the value of eccentric pre-stressing force for the condition is bottom fiber stress is nullify the bottom fiber stress. That means bottom fiber stress is equal to 0. The equation for finding out the bottom fiber stress in the case of an eccentric tendon, that is P by A plus PE by Z minus MD by Z minus ML by Z. We have to find out the value of P when this equation is equal to 0. Okay. That means P by A plus PE by Z minus MD by Z minus ML by Z is equal to 0. We know the value of A, Z, MD and ML. Then we have to find out PE. P is unknown here and what is E? Is given as eccentricity of pre-stressing force located at 100 mm from the bottom of the beam. Okay. Okay. Let me distance between the center of gravity of concrete. Center of gravity of concrete is the total depth is 200 by 300 mm. That means total depth is 300. Therefore, center of gravity of concrete is 300 by 2, that is 150. And the steel is located at 100 mm from the bottom. That means distance between the center of gravity of concrete and center of gravity of steel, that is 50 mm. So, you know the value of E. Then only unknown is P. P can be calculated, that is equal to 24.48 kN. Okay. That means the A can be calculated by B into D since it is a rectangular section. Z can be calculated by using BD square by 6 since it is a rectangular section. ML and MD that will be W into L square by 8. And E is the eccentricity that will be the distance between the center of gravity of concrete and steel. Then moving on to the next problem. A rectangular beam of cross section 200 mm by 300 mm, pre-stressed by 15 numbers of 5 mm diameter bars located at 65 mm from the bottom of the beam and 3 numbers of 5 mm diameter bars located at 25 mm from the top of the beam. That means the figure will be like this. Rectangular beam of cross-section 200 mm by 300 mm. There are 3 numbers of 5 mm diameter bar located at 25 mm from the top of the beam. And 15 numbers of 5 mm diameter bar will be at 65 mm from bottom of the beam. Okay. Assume stress in steel as 840 MPa. Calculate stresses at extreme fiber of mid-span. When the beam is supporting a live load of 6 kN per meter in addition to its self weight. Span is equal to 6 meter. Okay. Hope you got the question. You have to find out the stresses at the extreme fiber. That means you have to find out the top fiber stress as well as the bottom fiber stress. Then first let's check if there is an eccentricity or not. Since the distribution of steel is not symmetrical, that means there will be some eccentricity. Then we say have to consider the case B, stress distribution due to eccentric tendon. Have to find out both the cases, working stress at top fiber as well as working stress at the bottom fiber. Now to find out these stresses, you have to find out the values of P, A, E, Z, MD and MD. Then firstly, question is here. Okay. Then P by A. Then how will you find out the value of P? P means it is the pre-stressing force. That pre-stressing force is developed due to the steel. We have to find out the pre-stressing force developed by the steel. In order to find out this force, we know the value of stress in steel as 840 MPa. We know the area. From the equation, force stress is equal to force by area, or force is equal to stress into area, we can calculate the force developed by the steel. Force is equal to stress in wires into area of the wire. Stress in wires, that is given as 840. Then area of wire, we know 15 numbers of 5 mm diameter and 3 numbers of 5 mm diameter. That means there are 18 numbers of 5 mm diameter. That means area of cross section of the steel, that will be 18 into pi by 4 into 5 square. Speak out the value of P. P by A. A means area of the cross section of the B, that is 200 by 300. We got the value of P and A. Then we can calculate what is P by A. P by A is 4.948. The next term is PE by Z. You know the value of P. Then next is E. E means eccentricity, that is the distance between the center of gravity of concrete and steel. The center of gravity of concrete, that will be at, the center of gravity of the concrete, that will be at 300 by 2, that is 150. Then where will be the center of gravity of the steel? Then you have to find out the center of gravity. Then for finding out the center of gravity, we can use the equation x bar or y bar is equal to a1 x1 plus a2 x2 divided by a1 plus a2. Then here a1 means 3 into pi by 4 t square and a2 means 15 into pi by 4 t square. In all the cases, you know, for all the bars, diameter is same, that is equal to 5 mm. That means pi by 4 d square, that can be cancelled. So a1 means 15 into pi by 4 d square into y1 means the center of gravity of a1 from the bottom of the beam, that is 65. Then a2 will be 3 into pi by 4 into 5 square. Then center of gravity of a2 from the bottom of the steel, that will be 300 minus 25, that is 275, divided by a1 plus a2, that means 15 into pi by 4 d square plus 3 into pi by 4 d square. Then we can neglect the pi by 4 d square from here. Then the remaining is 15 into 65 plus 3 into 275 divided by 15 plus 3. Therefore, the center of gravity of steel will be at 100 mm from the bottom of the beam. And center of gravity of concrete will be 150 mm from the bottom of the beam. Therefore, eccentricity is the distance between these two, that means 50 mm. Then we got P and E. Then next is Z. Z means BD square by 6, that is 200 into 300 square by 6. The value is this much. Then we can calculate what is PE by Z. The value is equal to 4.948. The next is ML by Z and MD by Z. You know the value of Z. Then we have to find out what is ML as well as MD. ML and MD can be calculated by using WL square by 8. WL is given as 6, that means 6 into 6 square by 8, that is ML. Then we can calculate what is ML by Z, that is 9 Newton per mm square. Then MD means WL square by 8, WD means density of concrete into area, that is 6.48 kilo Newton meter. After getting MD, then MD by Z, that is 2.16. Then you got all the terms P by A, PA by Z, ML by Z and MD by Z. Just substitute in the equation for top fiber stress and bottom fiber stress. Then you will get, as the stress in the top fiber is equal to 11.16 MPa and stress at the bottom fiber is equal to minus 1.264 MPa. Thank you.